Hello students. So students, in the previous part of the video we have discussed the topic argand plane and the polar representation of a complex number, okay? And based upon that topic I have solved one example also, okay? So in the today's video we will solve exercise 5.2 from NCERT, okay? So our first question of NCERT 5.2 is that find the modulus and the argument of each of the following complex number from question number 1 to question number 2. Okay, student, I am considering that you all having your NCERT book so that you can understand the question. Okay, so in the first two question, students, we have to solve the modulus and argument for each complex number. Okay, so the first question is that z equal to minus 1 minus I root 3. Okay, this is the first question, student, of exercise 5.2. And for the first two question we have to solve the modulus as well as the argument of a complex number. Okay, so student, you know that what is the formula of modulus if a complex number z is there. So what will be the modulus? Modulus of z is equal to what? The formula is real part of z square plus imaginary part of z square. Okay, this is the formula of modulus of z. So whenever we will find the modulus of z for any complex number, we can apply this formula. Okay, so first we will solve mod of z. So what will be mod of z, student? Mod of z will be equal to under root. In the first question you will write the formula, in the second question you can solve directly. Okay, so I'm going to write the mod of z, z is equal to real part of z square plus imaginary part of z ka square. RE of z का मतलब होता है real part of z and IMZ of z का मतलब होता है imaginary part of z. Okay, real part, imaginary part. So for this question, student, I can say the real part of this complex number is minus 1, so minus 1 का square plus, and the imaginary part is minus under root 3, because our basic complex number is like that, a plus ib form. This is the general form of any complex number, but in the question here is minus, so we will take the minus sign also. When we will compare this complex number to this complex number, the value of a will be minus 1 and the value of b will be minus root 3. So by comparing we can get the values. Now what is the mod of z? Mod of z will be equal to minus 1 ka square will be 1 and root 3. So minus root 3 ka square will be 3. So mod of z will equal to under root 4. So mod of z will be equal to 2. Okay, now we have calculated the value of mod of z. Now what we have to find, student? Now in the second part we have to find the argument of complex number. And what is argument? Argument is represented by theta. Okay, it means we have to find the value of theta. So student, for finding theta I told you one formula, that first you have to calculate alpha, where alpha is the acute angle. After that you have to see the points, means you have to see the ordered pair, and according to the ordered pair the value of argument varies. Okay, so for this question, student, if I will compare this number. Now, I am solving for argument, okay? For argument of z. Okay? When I will compare this complex number with z equal to x plus iy, when I will compare this complex number with z equal to x plus iy, I can write by comparing z with x plus iy, I can say the value of x is equal to minus 1 and the value of y is equal to minus root 3. Okay. If I will compare this complex number to the general form, that is z equal to x plus iy, so x will be equal to minus 1 and y will be equal to minus root 3. Now, I told you first calculate the value of alpha, and I told you the formula that tan of alpha is equal to mod of y by x. Okay, tan of alpha is equal to mod of y by x. Okay, now tan alpha will be equal to what? Y is minus root 3 and x is minus 1. So minus will be cancelled to minus. So in the mod, root 3 will come, which will be equal to tan alpha equal to root 3. Okay, here you will write where alpha is acute angle. Alpha is acute angle. Okay, now tan alpha equal to root 3. We have to take the value of alpha so that the tan alpha equal to root 3. So we all know that tan 60 value is root 3. So I can write tan alpha will be equal to tan pi by 3. Tan pi by 3 or tan 60. Here I have written angle in the radian. So from here I can write alpha equal to pi by 3. So by that I have calculated the value of alpha. Okay. Now student, what you have to do after this you have to see the location of a complex number. Location of a complex number means in which quadrant the complex number lies. Okay, so by seeing the complex number, we can say na, the ordered pair will be minus 1 and minus root 3, because the value of x is minus 1 and the value of y is minus root 3. Okay, this is the ordered pair, and by seeing the ordered pair, we can say z lies in which quadrant, student? Minus minus is the quadrant, is the point in third quadrant. So we can say z lies in third quadrant. Okay, z lies in third quadrant. Now z lies in third quadrant, so I'm going to erase this, student. If a complex number lies in the third quadrant, so in that case, argument of z, which is also equal to what? Theta. Argument of z is represented by theta, and which is equal to minus pi minus alpha. This formula I told you in the previous part. Okay, if a complex number lies in the third quadrant, then the argument of z will be equal to minus of pi minus alpha, and argument of z can be represented by theta. So here, from here we can say theta is equal to what? Minus pi minus, the value of alpha is pi by 3. Okay, so theta is equal to, student, minus 2 pi by 3. Okay, theta, or and theta is also known as argument of z. Okay, so argument of complex number z equal to minus 2 pi by 3. In place of theta, you can write argument of z also. So argument of z is equal to minus 2 pi by 3. So by this, student, you can solve the argument of any complex number. If you know the position of a complex number, you can easily solve. Okay, and why I told you that formula? That because whenever you find the argument, generally we write the principal argument, and we all know that principal argument lies between minus pi to pi. Minus pi to pi matlab ki uski value minus pi se pi ke beech mein hi hoga. So minus 2 pi by 3 is equal to minus 120 degree. Aur aapko pata hai minus pi kitna hua, minus 180 degree, aur plus pi 180 degree. To ye jo value aa rahi hai, ye minus pi se pi ke beech mein hai, to hamara answer ye kya hai? Sahi. ऐसे तो आर्गुमेंट इनफाइनाइट हो सकते हैं, लेकिन हम लोग कोई एक पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू लिखते हैं, और जनरली हम लोग क्या लिखते हैं? प्रिंसिपल आर्गुमेंट, जो कि माइनस पाई से पाई के बीच में लाई करता है. ठीक है, जो फॉर्मूला मैंने बताया था, अगर आप वो अप्लाई करोगे तो यू कैन इजीली सॉल्व. ओके, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू फाइंड द अल्फा, देन यू हैव टू सी द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर. बाय सीइंग द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर यू हैव टू अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला. ओके, सो दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन यू कैन सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. So after this, I am going to solve question number 3. Okay? So please note down, student. Now, student, from question number 3 to question number 8, we have to represent the given complex number into the polar form. Okay? From question number 3 to question number 8, we have to represent each complex number into the polar form. Okay? So, what will be the step, student? Whatever complex number is given, you will assume it small z. Okay? So, what I will write, let z equal to 1 minus I. Okay? Suppose z equal to 1 minus I is there. Now, when I will compare this complex number to what? Z equal to xy. Z is equal to x plus iy. When I will compare this complex number to the original general form, that is z equal to x plus iy. So, I can say na, by comparing, I can write what? It is the given complex number and it is the general form of any complex number. So whenever I will compare this complex number to the general form, I will get the value of x equal to 1 and the value of y equal to what? Minus 1. Okay? Minus 1 I will get. Now student, because we have to represent z in polar form. So what is the formula of polar form? Polar form formula is r in bracket cos theta plus I sin theta. Any complex number can be represented in polar form like this. Okay? So r cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay? So student, we know now, if we will multiply this r in the bracket, I will get r cos theta plus I into r sin theta. This is because we are converting this complex number into the polar form. So P of z is equal to r cos theta plus I r sin theta. Now student, when I have told you the polar representation of a complex number, I said that x was equal to r cos theta and y was equal to r sin theta. I told you that thing. Because in polar form, what we do? We put the value of x and y in terms of r and theta. Whenever we convert, I am going to repeat one more time. Whenever we convert any complex number to the polar form, then what we do, in place of x and y, we put the value in terms of r and theta. We put the value of x in terms of r and theta, and we put the value of y is also in r and theta. So we know now, x is also equal to r cos theta. So r cos theta equal to 1 and r sin theta equal to minus 1. This is known as, okay? This we know that x was equal to what? r cos theta and y was equal to r sin theta. So because we are converting it in polar form, so in place of x we can put r cos theta, in place of y we can put r sin theta. Okay? This I have written for understanding of yours. Okay? Otherwise, if you will write the notes, you can easily understand. Now what you do again, when I solve the example, what I have done? I have done the squaring of both two equations and I have added them. Why I have added them? Because when you will add the square of these two, na, left side will come r square in bracket cos square plus sin square theta, and right side will be 1 square plus 1 square. So in the left side there will form one identity. So what I will do, first I will do the square of these two. So what I will get, student? I will get r square cos square theta equal to 1, because 1 ka square to 1 hi aayega, or I can write like this. And similarly r square sin square theta equal to minus 1 ka square. Now what I have to do, I have to add these two equations. So when I will add these two equations, left side will be added to left side, right side will be added to right side. So see, here it will come r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta equal to 1 square plus minus 1 square. Okay? Now, when I will take the common of r square from here, I will get in bracket cos square theta plus sin square theta, and in the left side, right side, it will come 1 plus 1. So it will be r square into 1, because cos square theta plus sin square theta equal to 1, equal to 2. So r square will be equal to 2. So r will be equal to under root 2. Whenever you will calculate the value of r, it will always be positive. Why it will be positive, student? Because in the explanation of the polar form, I told you r is equal to mod of z. जो r होता है वो किसके बराबर होता है? Mod of z के बराबर होता है, ठीक है? और mod of z हमेशा positive number होगा, तो that's why हम लोग यहाँ पर केवल positive sign लेंगे, negative sign नहीं लेते हैं, ठीक है? Always we take positive side because r is equal to mod of z. जब आप देखोगे वो तो आपको समझ में आएगा, ठीक है? Now r equal to root 2, so we have find the value of r, ठीक है? अब देखो r तो मिल गया, now we have to find the value of theta, means argument of z. तो argument of z मैंने आपको निकालना बताया है. पहले आप क्या करो, for argument of z which is also known as theta, for argument of z which is also known as theta, what we will do, student? We will find first tan alpha is equal to mod of y by x. We will find this, okay, where alpha is acute angle, where alpha is acute angle. Now this we are doing for finding theta, okay? Argument of z is represented by theta only. So tan alpha will be equal to what, student? Mod. Now the value of y is minus 1 and the value of x is 1. So see, minus 1 by 1 will come, mod of minus 1, and mod of minus 1 means mod of a negative number is always a positive. किसी भी चीज का जो mod होता है वो हमेशा positive ही होता है, चाहे वो number negative हो चाहे positive. So mod of minus 1 will be equal to 1. So here I can write tan alpha equal to 1. So by solving tan alpha equal to 1 and alpha is the acute angle, so for what values of alpha, tan alpha will be equal to 1? Tan ke kis value mein uski value, tan ke kis angle mein uski value kitni aati hai? 1. To tan 45 mein aati hai. To tan alpha can be written as tan pi by 4. 45 degree ko radian mein pi by 4 likhte hain. So from here I can write alpha is equal to pi by 4. ठीक है, अल्फा मिल गया. याद रखना अल्फा क्या है? एक्यूट एंगल. एक्यूट एंगल है तो 0 से 90 के बीच में ही होगा. तो आपको भी पता है 0 से 90 तक तो वैल्यू आपको पता ही है. तो 10 के किस वैल्यू में, किस एंगल में उसकी वैल्यू बन आती है? तो 45 डिग्री में आती है, दैट इज इक्वल टू पाई बाई 4. नाउ आफ्टर दिस वी विल सी द लोकेशन ऑफ अ पॉइंट. जब भी हम आर्गुमेंट फाइंड करते हैं तो हम लोग ये देखते हैं कि वो कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर कहां पर लाई कर रहा है, किस क्वाड्रेंट में. तो व्हेन वी विल सी द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर फॉर दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, so ordered pair will be what, student? Ordered pair is, see, x is 1 and y is minus 1, so 1 minus 1. So 1 minus 1 means the value of x is 1 and the value of y is minus 1. So for this ordered pair, the complex number z will lie in fourth quadrant, because the sign of fourth quadrant is plus minus. Okay, so we can say, so z will lie in fourth quadrant, okay? And for fourth quadrant, student, for fourth quadrant we know that argument of z equal to what? Minus alpha. I told you for fourth quadrant in the formula, I told you argument of z equal to what? Minus alpha. So argument of z equal to minus pi by 4, and argument of z is represented by theta, so theta is equal to minus pi by 4. Okay, just you have to remember the formula. First you have to calculate alpha. After that you have to see in which quadrant the complex number lies. According to the position of the complex number you will apply the formula. Okay, so by doing all this, see, student, whenever we convert any complex number into the polar form, first we calculate the value of r, and after that we calculate the value of theta. So r value we have calculated, that was root 2, and argument of z, that is theta, is calculated by minus pi by 4. So student, so the polar form of complex number z, the polar form of complex number z is p of z. I told you p of z, and the formula of p of z is equal to r in bracket cos theta plus I sin theta, where theta is what? Argument. Theta is known as argument of z. See here I have written. So put all the values of r and theta. So p of z will be equal to what? R is root 2, and this is cos theta is minus pi by 4 plus I sin minus pi by 4. Okay, now either you can leave your answer up to this, or you can solve further more. See, it is cos minus theta, it is sin minus theta. I told you in the third chapter that cos minus theta equal to cos, here I can write cos minus theta equal to cos theta, and sin minus theta equal to minus sin theta. ठीक है, cos minus theta equal to cos theta and sin minus theta equal to minus sin theta. So it's your wish, either you can leave your answer up to this, or you can write this step, that is root 2, this will become positive, so it will be cos pi by 4, and this will become negative, minus sin pi by 4. This will become because we know sin minus theta equal to minus sin theta. This minus sign comes outside. So when this minus sign will come outside, what will become, student? Here is plus, and when it will come outside, it will become minus I sin pi by 4. So this is the correct and proper answer. If you will write your answer up to this, this is also correct. But because you know the formula of cos minus theta and sin minus theta, so you can apply this formula also, okay? So this is the polar representation of 1 minus I, okay? Note down, student. One more question I will tell you, so that your doubt is clear. Now student, the next question is question number 4, that is minus 1 plus I. You have to represent this complex number into the polar form. So again the same thing, we will assume that let z equal to minus 1 plus I. Okay, let z is a complex number and z equal to minus 1 plus I. Now when I will compare this complex number with z equal to x plus iy, okay, so the value of x will be minus 1 and the value of y will be 1. So by comparing given complex number with z equal to x plus iy, what we can say? X will be equal to minus 1 and y will be equal to 1. Okay, after comparing this with the general form of a complex number, we will get x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 1. After this, student, what we will say? Because we are converting this complex number into the polar form, so the value of x is, we know that x is equal to r cos theta equal to minus 1 and y is r sin theta equal to 1. Okay, because when we have applied in the polar form, we got the value of x in terms of r and theta, and value of x was r cos theta and value of y is r sin theta. So in place of x I have put r cos theta, in place of y I have put r sin theta. Okay, now again same thing, for calculating r it is very simple, just do the square of these two and add it. So I am going to do that directly. So when I will do the squaring of these two and when we will add them, what I will get? R square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta इक्वल टू माइनस वन स्क्वायर प्लस वन स्क्वायर. ठीक है, व्हाट आई हैव डन, फर्स्ट आई हैव डन द स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस टू एंड देन आई हैव एडेड लाइक द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन. सो सी हियर विल बिकम इन आर स्क्वायर इन ब्रैकेट कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा एंड हियर इट विल बिकम वन प्लस वन. नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा इज वन, सो हियर विल बी आर स्क्वायर इन टू वन एंड हियर विल बी टू. सो आर स्क्वायर विल बी टू, सो आर विल बी अंडर रूट टू. फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग आर वी टेक ओनली पॉजिटिव वैल्यू दैट इज रूट टू बिकॉज वी ऑल नो दैट ना एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू फोर, सो एक्स विल बी प्लस माइनस टू. बट इन केस ऑफ कैलकुलेटिंग आर वी ऑलवेज टेक द पॉजिटिव वैल्यू दैट इज रूट टू. नाउ वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड वॉट, वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड आर. नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट थीटा so that we can represent this complex number into the polar form. So for theta and theta is also known as argument of z, what we will do, we will find out tan alpha first and tan alpha is equal to mod of y by x. Okay, this is for theta. So tan alpha, and alpha is what student, where alpha is acute angle. Alpha is acute angle. ठीक है, now see, so tan alpha will be what student, tan alpha will be mod, value of y is what, value of y is 1 and the value of x is minus 1. ठीक है, so it will come tan alpha will be equal to what, mod of minus 1, so tan alpha will be equal to 1 only. Because mod of a positive as well as negative number is always positive. So now, for which angle the value of 10 is equal to 1? So the angle will be 45. 10 ke kis angle mein uski value kitni ho jati hai 1? So that is 45 degree. So from here I can write 10 alpha equal to 10 pi by 4. So alpha will be equal to pi by 4. Okay? So alpha we have calculated. Now we will see where the complex number lies, means in which quadrant the complex number lies. So first we will see the ordered pair, and ordered pair is the value of x comma y, the value of x is minus 1 and the value of y is 1. So see student by seeing this ordered pair, we can say na this point, this ordered pair lies in which quadrant, second quadrant, because the sign of the second quadrant is minus and plus. We all know that whatever point lies in the second quadrant, their sign is minus and plus, and here is also minus and plus. So we can say, so z will lie in second quadrant. Okay, means complex number will lie in second quadrant, and if complex number lies in second quadrant, theta, which is also known as argument of z, is equal to what, pi minus alpha. I told you the formula, either you will write this or this, both are same. Okay, argument of z is same as theta, argument of z ko hi theta se represent kiya jata hai. To chahe to aap dono likh lo, chahe to aap theta likh lo, chahe to aap argument of z likh lo, as your wish. Main dono isliye likh raha hu ki dono same hote hain taki aapko samajh mein aaye. Now alpha we have calculated. So the value of theta will be student what, pi minus pi by 4. So when you will solve this student, you will get the value of theta equal to 3 pi by 4. Okay, theta will be equal to 3 pi by 4. So we have calculated the value of r, we have calculated the value of theta. So student, now we have to represent in polar form. Now we have to represent this in polar form. So after this I am solving here. Okay, so the polar form of z is p of z, and p of z is equal to r in bracket cos theta plus I sin theta. So now put the value of r and theta. So p of z is equal to the value of r is root 2 and value of theta is 3 pi by 4. So I have put the values. So that will be your answer, student. This will be your answer. Okay? So please note down it. Now, student, if you have understood these type of questions, so you can solve the remaining questions also. Okay? All questions are same. Okay? So I hope you have understood this question. So now see, student, whatever questions are left in this exercise, you can complete by yourself. Okay? You can complete by yourself. Whatever method I have applied, same method you will apply, then you can easily get the answer. Okay? See, many of the student will have the problem in question number 6. I can give the hint. Question number 6 is -3. Okay? This is the question number 6 is what? Question number 6 is -3. So -3 is also a complex number, but it does not have the imaginary part. So I told you, now if a complex number have only real part, that can be represented in this form, x plus I into 0. Yesterday I told you. So first, what you will do, you will write z equal to -3, or you can write z equal to -3 plus I into 0. Okay? This thing can be written like this also, because there is no imaginary part, but in the form of x plus iy, we can write this. So first we will write this. So by comparing this with the general form, that is z equal to x plus iy, I will get the value of x is -3 and the value of y will be 0. Okay? And the value of x will be r cos theta, and the value of y will be r sin theta. After that, you will do the squaring. The value of x is r cos theta, so r cos theta equal to 3, and r sin theta, r cos theta equal to -3, and r sin theta equal to 0. After that, you will find the value of r. You will find the value of r. Okay? So from here, what we will do, we will do the squaring of these two and we will add them so that we can get the value of r. After that, we will see the c for the argument, that is known as theta. So whenever we will find the theta, we will use tan alpha equal to mod of y by x. Y is what? 0. So it will be 0 by -3. So 0 by -3 will be equal to only 0, student. So tan of alpha equal to 0. So alpha will be equal to what? 0 degree. So alpha is a 0 degree. So theta will also be a 0 degree. Okay? Theta will also be a 0 degree. Okay? So theta will be equal to alpha. So theta will be equal to 0. So r you have calculated, theta you have calculated, then you can represent in polar form. Same concept will be applied in question number 8 also. Okay, so you will try. If any problem will be there, you can ask. Okay, method is same. Whatever method I have applied, student, same you have to apply. Okay, one more thing. What will be the value of pi here? What will be the value of pi, what will be the value of theta here? See, when for question number 6, student, see, question was -3 na, and z equal to -3 plus I 0. Okay? When we will write the ordered pair of this complex number, the ordered pair of this complex number will be -3, 0, student. Okay? And -3, 0 does not lie in any of the quadrant. It is lying on the axis, means -3, 0 will lie here. -3, 0 will lie here. Okay? So at this point, what is the angle made, student? The angle made is known as, the angle made is calculated by the positive x-axis. Either you will go here or you can write here. Okay? So in this case, na, theta will be either pi or minus pi. Theta will be either pi or minus pi. Why pi and minus pi both? Because if you will move from this direction, means anti-clockwise, then this angle, at this point, angle will be pi, means 180 degree, and when you will move in the clockwise direction, it will be minus 180 degree. So 180 degree can be represented by pi, and minus 180 degree can be represented by minus pi. So for this question, my student, theta will come what? Pi. Okay? Theta will come pi. You can take pi. So when you will write the polar form, so polar form will be r cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay? This you can write, and the value of r will be 3 only. The value of r will come 3. After solution, you can get the value of r, that is 3. And it is cos pi and it is plus I sin pi. This will be the answer. Here minus sign can also come, okay? So the purpose is that you have to visualize the location of the point. You can visualize. Agar yahi cheez 3 comma 0 minus 3 comma 0 nahi hoti, kya hoti 3 comma 0. Agar yahi cheez kya hoti minus 3 comma 0 nahi hoti, kya hoti 3 comma 0. To 3 comma 0 yahan par aata na student. 3 comma 0 positive x axis mein aata. To is case mein theta kitna hota? उस केस में थीटा 0 डिग्री होता है, क्योंकि इस एक्सिस पे जो एंगल बनता है 0 और नेगेटिव एक्सिस पे कितना बनता है 180. ठीक है, तो ये चीज आपको समझ में आना चाहिए. अगर क्वाड्रेंट में होगा तो पहचान ही जाओगे, लेकिन जब एक्सिस पे आएगा तो आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि वो पॉजिटिव एक्स एक्सिस पे आ रहा है या पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव एक्स एक्सिस पे आ रहा है. अगर पॉजिटिव में आएगा तो 0, नेगेटिव में आएगा तो 180. ऐसे ही अगर पॉजिटिव वाई एक्सिस पे आएगा तो पाई बाई 2 और नेगेटिव वाई एक्सिस पे आएगा तो माइनस पाई बाई 2. ठीक है, तो ये कॉन्सेप्ट आपको समझना होगा. बाकी सारी चीजें सेम ही है स्टूडेंट. सो आई होप यू कैन फिनिश एक्सरसाइज 5.2. ओके, व्हाटएवर द क्वेश्चंस आर रिमेनिंग यू कैन सॉल्व बाय योरसेल्फ. वन मोर थिंग, द मिसलेनियस एग्जाम मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू विल हैव टू सॉल्व. ओके, बिकॉज देयर आर वेरी गुड क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन. ओके, सो आई विल टेल यू अप टू एक्सरसाइज 5.3 and 2 or 3 important question I will solve, and remaining exercise you will solve by yourself. Students, if you have watched all the videos now, I am telling you, you will be able to solve all questions. All question means the miscellaneous exercise also. Okay, so whatever parts I have uploaded of this chapter, please go through it one by one in sequence. Not in that if you are watching on one day part 1, then you will watch part 5. No. Part 1, then part 2, then part 3, then part 4, and so on. Okay? If you will study like this, I am telling you, there will not be any doubt. Okay? So I hope you have understood. In the next class, we will solve our exercise 5.3. Okay? So till then, students, have a nice day. Take care. Thank you.